In this video, we are going to talk about trim tabs. The trim tabs are a set of flaps mounted on the transom, on both sides, using joints and an adjustment system. They can be operated individually upwards or downwards. The trim tabs serve two basic purposes. Keep the bow lowered or raised. To raise one of the sides of the boat. Thus, the flaps allow the longitudinal and transverse trim of the boat to be modified according to sea conditions, speed, load, and wind. Depending on the type of boat, the trim tabs will be a supplementary or unique system to control the boat's trim angle. It will be a complementary trim system for boats equipped with stern drives or outboards with power trim. In all other cases, such as shaft drive boats, it will be the only system for adjusting the boat's trim angle. How do trim tabs work? When the trim tabs are flush to the bottom of the boat, they have little or no effect and present very little resistance. The trim tabs begin to work when lowered and modify the water flow past the bottom of the boat. When the two trim tabs move downward, water flow through the bottom of the boat is modified, creating a hydrodynamic pressure, which generates an upward force. This force causes the stern to rise and the bow to descend. The amount of upward force generated by the trim tabs will depend on the surface area of the flap, the speed at which the boat is traveling, and the angle of inclination relative to the bottom of the boat. Correctly dimensioned trim tabs will allow the boat to reach the planing speed with less effort, time, and fuel consumption. When accelerating, the stern of the boat will sink and the bow will rise. Lowering the trim tabs while the boat is increasing speed prevents the stern from sinking excessively, allowing the boat to start planing sooner. Accelerating while lowering the trim tabs without releasing the rudder can be tricky. A simpler alternative is to lower the trim tabs at a certain angle before accelerating. Once planing is achieved, adjust the trim tabs to the optimum position. By performing various tests, we can determine an initial reference angle at which the trim tabs should be lowered before starting to accelerate to achieve an efficient planing. For the correct use of the trim tabs on a boat, it is necessary to experiment by raising and lowering the trim tabs smoothly, observing how the boat reacts to get to know its optimum operating angles. Influence on longitudinal stability. When the trim tabs start to be lowered, the stern rises and the boat ascends, producing a longitudinal lengthening of the wetted planing surface. This lengthening gives greater longitudinal stability to the boat and generates greater sailing comfort. In addition, when the trim is optimal, you will notice that the boat's steering responds more smoothly. Trim tabs are also often a solution for boats that suffer from porpoising because they allow more accurate adjustment of the longitudinal axis of the boat. When porpoising appears, trim tabs should be lowered gently until the phenomenon is mitigated or disappears. Influence on transverse stability, correct heeling. The main advantage of the trim tabs over other trim systems is that each flap can be adjusted independently, allowing the transverse trim of the boat to be modified while sailing. This makes it possible to level the boat in cases where the boat heels, either because there is more load on one side due to the wind or for other reasons. To compensate for this heeling, it is sufficient to lower the flap of the side to be lifted gradually. This adjustment must be made slowly, controlling the effects of the adjustment on the navigation and the boat's behavior. Use of trim tabs during navigation. When reversing, it is important that the trim tabs are not lowered because if they are lowered, they will produce a drag resistance that will hinder maneuverability and generate a strange behavior of the boat. Sailing in choppy head seas. In situations where you are sailing in head seas and the waves hit the bottom of the hull repeatedly, it is advisable to lower the trim tabs so that the bow descends and has greater contact with the water, allowing the sharp lower part of the hull to cut the waves, reducing the impact force of the waves against the hull and achieving greater boat control and sailing more comfortably. We can see two towing tank tests made for the same hull model, in which one test is performed with the trim tabs flush and the other with the trim tabs lowered by 17 degrees. As can be seen, the model with the trim tabs lowered has less pitching and, therefore, better sea keeping. Following sea. When sailing with a following sea and the speed of the boat is lower than the forward speed of the waves, the flaps should be fully retracted to have the best control of the boat. If the trim tabs are lowered, the rear part of the two flaps will act as a kind of wall on which the force of the waves and the current will impinge, generating dangerous imbalances in the boat. Beam sea. We are entering a somewhat complex section in which the use of the trim tabs will depend a lot on the state of the sea and the boat in which you are sailing. There are two ways to use the trim tabs in beam seas, two opposite ways. Lower the trim tab on the side opposite the waves, or lower the trim tab on the side where the waves are coming from. If the trim tab is lowered on the side that does not receive the waves, the boat can compensate for the heeling caused by the wind. At the same time, it will compensate for the skidding caused by the waves, since the lowered trim tab will cause the boat to tend to move to the opposite side. Lower the trim tab on the opposite side of the boat receives the waves is especially recommended for boats with a high center of gravity and a lot of dead rise, such as boats with a flying bridge. If the trim tab is lowered on the side from which the waves are coming, that side is raised, and the boat heels slightly to the opposite side. Raising the windward side reduces wind-blown spray and wave splash, making the ride drier and more comfortable. In addition, when the boat is tilted, the keel shifts to the side from which the waves are coming, decreasing the dead rise angle on the opposite side, and causing the roll to be reduced. Care must be taken when lifting the windward side of the boat, and never do so in waves that threaten to capsize the boat. In beam seas, if the boat cannot be righted before the next wave arrives, it is advisable to start sailing zigzagging. As a final conclusion, we could say that the trim tabs give a lot of possibilities in the handling of the boat if you know how to use them correctly.